you very much for your time, and I really enjoyed the series. And I wondered about the assets of grief, anger, and addiction. They show us a narrow path that is really interesting regarding the gray area of the characters. And do you think all the projects may follow?
Well, I sure hope so. It's kind of the only thing that interests me. I think Europeans in general have been more open to stories that embrace ambiguity and paradox and contradictions and the kind of mysteries of the human heart and human nature. I also think this television space is the space for those kind of stories. I think it just, for whatever reason, became harder and harder to motivate an audience to go out of their house and consume those kind of content theatrically. So drama almost became a dirty word in my experience as a producer. You know, if I was pitching something, I would always say, well, drama is a genre too, you know, because everybody always wanted genre content. But, you know, I think a lot of the, you know, best writing is now being done for television. And I think the things that really resonate most deeply with people are things that haven't been reduced to black and white. And a lot of, as I said, the kind of cinema of spectacle, which is a global business, it has to transcend language. It has to transcend cultural differences. You know, they're trying to make a product that's for the most people in the most countries. So it's mostly the language of action, which is universal, that everybody, you know, understands without feeling like something got lost in translation.
And